So recording has been started, and the today's session is regarding to YUM. So that is installing, updating software, any packages by using the YUM, that is a package manager. So the today's session is YUM. It means Yellow Dog Update Modifier. So this is a utility, this is a tool, this is a package manager that is used to install, update, remove any package that comes in RPM format. So we can install any package by using this particular package manager. So YUM is a package manager that is used to install the packages, and it automatically resolve the dependencies also. So today's session, in this session we will discuss all the concept. Okay. RPM I have completed already, but I will tell you for you. So what is RPM? RPM stands for RPM Package Manager, and sometimes we call it Red Hat Package Manager, because this is originally developed by Red Hat. And if I want to install any package and the package have some dependencies also, so RPM cannot work. So it not resolve the dependencies automatically. But in YUM, so we can use this and we can install any package, and all the package dependencies will resolve automatically. And some more differences also. So in a RPM, we install the packages individually one by one. And RPM also have some advanced options also, but mostly we use this because for this, we create just a repository, and from that repository, we can install the packages. The repository can be multiple. It can use multiple locations, but RPM cannot use the multiple locations. It only use the same location. Location means from the current location, install the packages. If we have package, then it will install. But YUM has the advanced features comparison to RPM. So in this, we can install the packages, we can update the packages, remove the packages, and also get the information regarding any software packages and its dependency. So it will resolve the dependencies automatically. And it will take different locations. It means we can create multiple repositories, and it can take from that repository and resolve all the things. So this is a small concept about the YUM. So YUM is a package manager. By using this particular YUM, we can install our packages that available in RPM format. So all the Linux, the packages, softwares available in .rpm format that comes in .rpm format. This. So we can use these RPM packages for the installation of any software. So we have some commands regarding the installation related. So we can use these commands by using the YUM. So YUM help, YUM list, YUM search. We have different commands. But first, I will tell you about how to create the YUM repository, how to create local YUM repository. So first, I will discuss about the creation. These are all the commands that can be performed if I have the YUM server. So today I will tell you about how to create the local YUM repository. So what is my today's session? So this is my topic, how to create YUM repository. YUM repository can be created locally, and it can also work by using some protocols. It means remotely also by using these protocols. It can be FTP protocol, it can be HTTP protocol, and anything that you want to use. Mostly we use these two concepts, that is FTP and HTTP. By using these two concepts, we can create the YUM repository that can be available within a network. It means remotely means by using the network, by using the internet, we can use within a network. Or it can be a, by using the internet also. So we can use this concept. But in this session, we discuss about only the locally concept, this one. So how to create a repository in your local machine? So you can install the packages. You can run these all the commands that is available. So how to create YUM repository, I will discuss in this session. So see. So create a local YUM repo. It's also known as repo. So for this, what are the requirements? So we require media of RHEL8. So if we have the media, then we can create the local. If we don't have media, you can download the packages from the internet also. Then you can create the YUM repository. But in the DVD, in my media of the RHEL, it means it can be your DVD, it can be your pen drive, any media you can have. And it can be your network also. So you should have the packages. Then you can create the repository. See. So run this particular command to check. We have the media in my machine. It means RHEL image. So this is my RHEL DVD that I have inserted in my machine that is available in this particular location. So this is the location where my DVD is mounted. So this is the location, run media root RHEL. So this is the location, and this is the size, and this is the type. If I remove this particular media that is not available in my machine, suppose if I remove this my DVD, it means CD, DVD, disconnect, then you can see. If you don't have the media, you cannot create local YUM repository. So you should have to download from the internet. But we have the media, then insert my DVD in my machine. So first you should have to connect your DVD in your machine, then you are able to create. See again. So this one. So my DVD is available now. Then you can create. So these are the steps. What is the step one? Go to the location /etc/yum.repos.d. This is the location where you create a repo file. You should have to provide the location where all the packages are available. So YUM can understand in which location it will get all the packages. So this is the location where you should install. You should create a repo file. But in this, we have already created a repo. So I will move to see here. You can check. YUM repo list. Or you can check, we have YUM repository, it is by default enabled in my machine. So I will take the another machine, that is fresh machine. This is my fresh machine. So you can so now check in this YUM is created, YUM is configured or not, because RPM is already available in your machine, but YUM you should have to configure in all Linux machines. That is not available in Red Hat. That is available in CentOS also, but in this you should have to create this. So see, cd /etc/yum.repos.d. So this is the location. See, there is no repo file here. This is the default file. You can see this. Just so this will provide the information. You can also subscribe by using the subscribe manager. So this will provide some information. So for creating local repository, goes to this particular location first, then create a repo file like this. We have already a repo file here. See, this is my repo file. And what is the information in this repo? So I already told you in RPM session, in your DVD, there are two folders available. See, go to the computer location and see what are the folders that are available. So go to root, in this root, go okay, that is not root, that is run, this one. In this, go to the root location, that is media root. So this is your DVD, this is the location. In this, there are two folders. In these two folders, all the packages are available. If you are using a RHEL 7 version, only one folder is available, one directory is available, that is known as packages. But in RHEL 8, we have two folders. In these two folders, all the packages are available. So you should have to copy this particular DVD in your local machine. Then you can able to create YUM repository. If you do not want to copy this in your local machine, you can also use the DVD, but you should have to insert this at the time of the installation. So the packages will get from your DVD. So this is the concept. So in this check, all the packages are available. We have all the packages. So for the installation, we require these packages. So these all packages have the extension, that is RPM. This is a package. So these have all the packages. These are the packages that need. So this is the repo file, repository. If you download the all packages, so you should have to create the repo file, repository. So these all files are required. Just this one, these are required. These are mandatory. Do not delete this one. Your repo will not work. If only you have this package, you do not have this one, so your repo will not work. So this will require. This is already created folder in your machine, in your DVD, not machine, in your DVD. So there is another folder also, repo data also available, and these all the packages. You have all these packages. See, these all the packages are available in this. So first you should copy these DVD in your local machine. So what I will do? So this is the location. See here, I have copied this particular DVD in this particular location. See, in this, this folder is available. In this, this folder also available. So create this one. In this particular file, we have these lines. So give any name here, then name. So this script you should write to create the repo file. So in the repo file, what is available? This particular script is available. So you can install your packages from which particular location? From this particular folder and this particular location. And this is file, base URL, enable GPG check. You should have to write all these things. So how to create this one? I will show you. So first create this particular repo file. So give any name by using the Vim editor. Server local yum server. Give this particular name. The extension always remains same, that is repo. So you can provide any name here, then open this particular, then square bracket, give any name, but I have typed base OS, the same name, just like the folder. So I can understand this is for the base OS folder. Then provide any name here, but name will be same, equal will be same, give any name. Suppose this is a local and yum server. You can provide any name for the base OS. For the base OS, this one. Then provide, this is the name, just like a description. Then what you will provide? Then provide the base URL information. So this is my base URL information. In this, from base URL to file, all will be same, and this always same, toothless. It means this indicate these all packages are available in your local machine and the file name is this. So this indicates just the name of the file where all the packages are available. And third, fourth, suppose I have saved this particular, I have saved all the packages in which particular location? Suppose I have saved, so this is my RHEL DVD, RHEL 8 DVD, this is the name. But I have not created this one, but I create this later. And in this, there is a folder, the folder name is base OS, this one. So we don't need to give the space. Just for your understanding, I place this a different. So combine these three slash. So you don't need to give the space between these. So this is the location, then give slash again. Then enable this particular, enable, then one. One means you want to enable this. Then one more thing, that is GPG check, that is to be disabled because we don't need to check all the GPG concept. It means this one. I will show you ls slash rhel. In this upstream RHEL DVD, I will show you. This is not a directory, cd slash RHEL. Okay, then see, this is empty folder. Okay, df-ht, see in this location, there is a file related to this one, GPG check. So if I install any package, so it will check the integrity. This is digitally certified by the Red Hat or not. So in this, these are the key. So it will check the certificate. It means it will check the digital signature every time it installs the packages. So we should, I disable this one because we don't need to check. Then disable this. If you want to enable this, so you should have to provide the path of this particular GPG key. If you want to provide the path of this one, so you can also provide. How to provide? I will tell you this later. So this one. So do this. Just GPG check 0. So base URL, name, this one, this one. So these have 5 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just save this one. Then give a command yum repo list all. So this will show me one information, that is your status is enabled or not. See, this is the name of the repo. It means just work as a repo ID. This is the description. This is just description. It means repo name that I have provided in the repo file. And this is status. If I want to install any package, install telnet. See, this will give me a message, because in this particular location this package is not available, because this package is available in extreme folder. So this is a different location, and extreme is a different location. So we have two folders, and all the packages available in these two folders. Some are in this one and some in other folder. So give the path of this particular also. So copy all these lines. So these are 5 lines, then 5YY. That I have already told you how to copy these one. Press O, then again P. Then change, small change only, just give any name here again, that is upstream. STREAM, this one. So this is name same, that is upstream. Okay, upstream, good. Then change here also, and the last one, that is this one. Enable this one, disable this one, then check. Run again this particular command repo list to verify your yum repository is configured. Then you are able to install the package. Then run this particular command again and see RHEL 8DBT. This will show me error again. I already told you, because we don't have this particular location, because we should have to copy my DVD in my local machine. So this is the location, this is the path where all the packages will available. But I have created the repo file, just created the repo file. But you should have to copy your DVD in your local location that you have provided in this one. So we should have to copy this particular DVD in my local machine. In this particular location, in this there is no folder related to this particular name. So copy this name, then create mkdir, then in this location give this name. So see, this folder is available, but we don't have the packages. Then perform cp command hyphen rvf, then go to which particular location, this one. This one is the location. So copy this particular location, and in this copy all the files and folders. Then you are able to perform the yum commands, because the all packages available in this particular DVD, in this particular folder, this one. Then copy this in which particular location, RHEL 8DBT. It will take 2 and 3 minutes. so then my confession will be complete. So this is the last one concept, last one step that needed for to create a YUM local repository. So wait for 2 and 3 minutes. So Rahul, Vijay and Gopal, if any doubt, so you can ask after 2 and 3 minutes. So my DVD has been copied. Then run this command again. See this. This is already installed, but I want to remove this. So remove this first, then install again. So remove this one package. Press Y. Then see again. Now I am able to install this package. See all the information. I am not subscribed, so you don't need to take subscription of Red Hat for local YUM repository. See, so this will give some message. You are not registered, so don't focus on this one. See here, this is my package name, this is the architecture of this particular package, and this is the version of this particular package, and this is the place. The place can be 1, 2, 3, 4 and more. But in RPM you can install that particular package from only one location. It will not take automatically from the multiple location. See, I will see this concept. At this time this is only one place, but if we have a package that is stored in multiple location, that it will take automatically. See, this is my one package. What is the size of this particular package? So this one. So press Y. This package will be installed, and you want to install another one package also. Telnet-server, this one server. See, this will give me a message, but if you type here 1, it will automatically install. So we don't need to type Y and Y again and again. So this is the command. Suppose I will give one more, that is STTPD. See here, how many packages are available? 9 packages. What is the location? See here, this package is available in which location? This package is available in base OS folder, and this whole one available in upstream folder. So this is a different place and this is a different place. So this is the functionality of YUM. It will take a path from different locations, but RPM cannot take a path from different location, and it cannot resolve the dependencies automatically also. If I run this particular command by using telnet, see the difference. So press no here again. So this is my location /RHEL. Then okay, in this go to the location of upstream, because we have all the packages. Run this command rpm -IVH for installing STTPD. So in upstream, in packages, go to the location of packages, this one, then rpm -IVH, then give the name of the package. So this is my package name, this one, pd-2.2. Then see the difference. So error to fail. So you should have installed these all dependencies first, then I am able to install this particular package. So this will not resolve the dependencies automatically also, but I have some more concept in RPM also. See here. So this is these all concept that is already also you can use this. So this one no sign, these all. So these are some concepts. So we have one commands, this one, not this one. Okay. So it has also different. Do not verify package dependency. If you use this one command, that then package will install. But you should have to know all these things. Then you are able to perform that particular command. But in this one, you don't need to anything. Just run this particular command. If you want to install all the packages, then just type star. Star means all the packages. See here. How many packages at this time we have? This one. This is my package name. These are all the dependencies, and these are the dependencies. Then see again. If we type star here, all the related package that is available for the HTTPD, then see again how many packages. So these are the packages, this one and this not available at the time when we don't type the star. Then these are manual pages, tools. So it will install all the packages. So this is very simple. So you can install all the packages and all the dependencies, it will resolve automatically. So you don't need to type one by one. So this is very simple concept to install the packages. So mostly generally all the companies environments we use this, but sometimes we need to install individual package, then we can use RPM. So RPM is also a best concept. You don't need to create, you don't need to configure the RPM. RPM is default concept that is available, already available. So you don't need to configure anything. But for this one, you have to configure. You have to provide this particular location. Then it will able to install the package. So every concept have its own advantage and disadvantage. So just type Y here. Then you are able to install all the packages. So this is the concept how to install the package by using the yum utility. So this is my yum that I have configured in my machine. So what are the steps? I will yum.repos.d, this one. Okay, we have typed a wrong command, this one, and see. So this is the location where you should have to create this particular. So first, from the starting, if you want to create a local yum repo, or we can say that yum repository, so you should have some requirements. So DVD of RHEL 8, this one. First you should have this, then copy this particular. So you can copy first on the first time, copy this on your local machine. Then last one, that is create a repo file, this one. So this is the concept. So you can use. I will show one more concept also, that is, wait for 1 minute only. I've installed a just fresh machine. Here. So any doubt regarding this, how to create a, so this is the small concept. DVD you should have, copy this one, local machine, then create repo file, then perform this particular command, yum repo list all to check. Then if you want to install, then use yum install, yum remove. I will show all the commands and other command also. So this is just concept to create a local yum repository. See here, this is my another fresh machine, login this one. See. See one more small concept. Suppose yum repo list. This is my fresh machine. All just fresh. At this time, we have no repository available. See, but we have my DVD available. If I do not want to copy this my own machine, because maybe we don't have more space, because it will take 8 GB space in your machine. But you want just install one small package, just only one time, then you can also do this, but in a small manner. So you don't need to copy this in your local machine. If you do not want this one, then just do this one concept. Create a folder, RHEL, DVD, it just one, this not create this in slash location. So I have created one folder, that is RHEL8. At this time, see here, there is nothing in this. Just perform this one command. This first do this df-ht. See, then mount. So you don't need to remember all of these things. Just copy this one, paste here. Then copy this one, paste here. You have all these things. So this is the location where you want to mount all of these things. So this is your DVD. So you can mount this particular DVD in different location. So this is a long path, and you don't need to copy this one. So see, you have copy. See here. So RHEL8, all the DVD will available in this particular location. So not this one. I have type a wrong command here. This one. So all the DVD available in your this location. This one. Then see. See again. ls/RHEL. Then go to this location. This is my first step, not the second step. This is my first step. Do this one. Then go to this location, etc, em.repos.d. This is my second step. Go to this location. You don't have any file, then vim. Create any file, give any name, then give the extension will be repo. So it's called repository. Then if you already have a file anywhere, any location, suppose like this. So copy this whole thing from any location. So just create this only one time, then you can copy this whole thing in your mail and anything for the local only. Not for all the things, but if you want to change some location, so you can change the location. Just copy this one, then, but we have to change some this one. So this is this, and this also we need to change because my folder name is RHL8. In this, that folder will available. Then see PM repo list all. So now you are ready. You are able to install any package. PM install bind. This is a package of DNS. So you are able to install this particular package. So I have performed a small command history. How many commands we have? So see, this is my first command. So this one is your first command. Create a DVD, create a folder, and mount this particular DVD in your this particular location. This one. This is the location. So this is your first command. This is your second command. This is your third command. Create a repo file. This is your fourth command to check, and this is the way to install the packages. So this is a small concept. So if you want to install any package, so just first create a repository in your local machine. If you want to create a repository by using the internet, I will tell this later. So this is the concept, that is a local concept. So any doubt, Rahul and Gopi and Vijay, if anyone has doubt, so you can ask. Then we will tell about these whole things. So this is my topic. In your book, local repository path will not available. They not tell about the how to create the local repository. This is not in your course curriculum. In that, just create a link and copy that link. Then you are able to connect to internet. Then you can install the packages. Just small thing that I will tell you later. So this is the local concept. If I have time, then I will tell you about how to create using the FTP, using the HTTP. Because in company environments, mostly use this particular concept, not this one. This is only for you how to install the packages. So I will tell this later. This is not a big concept, but I will copy the whole path, then I will tell you. So I will from this one, see what is the use of this particular command. So these are the command that present in your book. So for this, using these commands, so you should first create the repository, then you can perform these commands also. Gopi, I have already updated all of these things, so please contact to ma'am, then she will share with you all the links related to. I have already shared all of these things. Day by day, I have shared. So then, if she will not share, then I will provide these all things personally. Okay. So contact the ma'am first, then I will also tell him about you. So she will share the all of the recordings, all of the records for you. So this is the first command, yum help. What is the use of this one? So just give me 1 minute. that. What is the use of yum help command? See, yum help. So this will provide all the help related to the yum. What are the commands that are available with this one? So these are the commands. It have more commands. These are all the options. If I want to check queue, version, no docs. So these are the commands related to this one. So we can also use this one. Then this is the second command. What is the use of list? It will display all the information related to the packages that is available in your system. So see here. So these are all the packages that are to be installed in your machine. But I want to check list this one. This package installed in my machine or not. So give this particular. So this will provide the information. At this time, this package is available. It means this is not installed in my machine. Available means this is not installed in my machine. If this package is installed in my machine, then this will tell that that is installed. See, if I install this particular package in my machine, then what message will display? This one. See, this is my package name. This is my architecture. This is my version. This is the location. From this particular location, it will capture this particular package, then install in my machine. See. So what message it will display? Incorrect checksum. I have one do one mistake, that is dev sr0 then slash rhl, because at this time there is no package available, because I mostly use this one concept. So just mount. So we need any time if I want to install the package, just mount this one. So in a one command my yum will be ready, because we have already the file. Then see this again. I want to install this one. So these packages will be installed. So see again this particular command, list command. So see what the message will be displayed in my terminal. So this is installed. So this is the name of the package and this is to be installed in my machine. If I want to check the another one, that is httpd. I want to check. So see here, this is also installed. Then see another one, bind bind. So what the message? This is installed, this is available. It means we have not installed this particular package in my machine. This is available in which particular location? Appstream. In Appstream, this package is available. So we can install this particular package from this one. So this is the use of this particular command. So we can check the information related to the installation that is available in your machine and that is also available in your yum repository. So this is the use of this one. So this has been completed. Then suppose if I don't know the name of the package, then how I can install? Suppose if I don't know this is the package of the DNS, I don't know, then what I will do? This is a package of DNS or not? Then you can use a command that is search, and I just know the name, just DNS. So type here DNS server, any name, any keyword that you know about that. So just So this will give me the information that is related to the this one, see here. But in this, there is no yum server available. So press just yum search all command. So it will provide all the information related to that package. So this is the yum, sorry, this is the DNS server package name. And what is the full form of this particular bind? Berkeley internet name domain. So this is a DNS server. DNS means domain name system. So this is a server. If I want to install this particular package in my machine, but I don't know the name of the DNS server, then what I do? So we should have to know about the this particular command. So this is a command by which we can recognize what is the name of that package. So this is the use of this particular command. So what is the use of this? So it will list the packages by the keyword found in the name and summary. It will also provide the summary only. So this is the use. Suppose if you want to search the package name of web server and its related summary, so you should provide this one, then this provide all of these things about that. Suppose we want to search about the web server. See, this is the web server. Then it will provide all the information. This is the summary that is matched for the web server. These are the packages, these one, Nginx. This is also related to the web server that is mostly used recently, Nginx. This is also web server. But I want to search all the information related to the web server because I want just HTTP, not just Nginx. So Nginx also available at this time. So this is a detailed summary. So it will provide the summary also, and it will also provide the description also. So this one, summary and description, you can tell. This will provide all the fields if I use this particular syntax. This is all. So this is Nginx. This is HTTP, and this is my package that I want to install. So this is related to the Apache or related to the HTTP server, related to the web server. We can call this web server, Apache server, HTTP server, anyone. And this is the different one that is used to provide the high performance for the web services, reverse proxy, and lot of advantages for the web server. So this is the use of this particular command. And if I want to get the information related to that package, then what I will do? So we can use this particular command, yum info package name. So this will provide the information related to that packages. And including how much space it will take, it will also display the information related to the space. And at the time of the installation, how much it will take. So this is used to get the information. If I want to get the information regarding the Apache, so type this one, see. So this is a command that is info and give the name of the package name, then httpd. So this will provide the detailed information. This also you can check this information, you can also check by using the RPM command that I have already told you in the earlier session. So see here, this one, if I use this one by using the RPM command, then what you will do? RPM hyphen QI, see here, same information. So this is related to the RPM and same. See, this is the name, this is the version, this is. So this is, this one is for this one, see here. So this is installed in my machine. This is the name, this is the version, this is the release, architecture, size, source, repository, repo, upstream, summary, Apache, URL, for this one, license version, ASL, Apache. So this will show all the information related to that package. So this is the command that you can use to check the information of that particular command. So this is the another one command. Suppose, Rahul, can you tell me, if I don't know the package name, then what you will do by using the RPM command? Because you are available in the last session, if you want to check the package name of Apache server, then which command you can use to check the name of the package? Suppose if I forget the name of my web server package, what is the name of my web server package, then how you can find this? Rahul, because you attend the last session related to the RPM, that I have already told you. You can also do the text in chat box so I can understand. No, this one is just for the query. I want to check the configuration file. No, I want to check the package name by using the configuration file. Then what you will do? Okay. See this one command. /where www.rpm-qc. Where w then html. See, but I have not installed the package. Yum install httpd. rpm-qc. rpm-qc. Okay. So this is your file, and by using this particular command you can check. So this is the name of the package that is available by this particular. So this is a package name. If I check here this one, I type the wrong information here, /etc in this httpd conf, in this conf httpd.conf, then it will take the information related to the package. This one, see here. So you can check this information. See, this one and this one is same. What is the name of my package? This one. See, this information and this information is same. So this is the command, this one. If I know the name of the configuration file and I forget the name of the package, then this command used with RPM. If the same thing I want to know about, if I have the file path and I want to check the name of the package, what is the name of the package that available from this particular file path? So we can use yum provides this path provided by this particular package. So we can use yum provides. See, yum provides is a command, and then give this information, this one. So this will tell about the package name of this particular configuration file. So this is the package that is provided by, this is the path that is provided by this particular package. Suppose if I install any software in my machine, then what will happen in my system? Some files, some folders will automatically created. So this configuration file, because this location is available already. See, I will tell you, just see here. See, this is the location. This is my file system. This file system will provided by this particular package. So for this particular path, this package is responsible. If I do one more thing, that is /etp, and see only this one. Check again, which package is responsible? This package is responsible for this particular location. So you can see, then again see, which package? This file system. This is a different package name, and this is a different package name. So this file system provided, it means this folder will automatically created when we install the file system. It means file system means this particular package. So this file system will be provided. Sometimes we know what is the file system of the Linux. The Linux file system will automatically created when we install the OS. Same like that, if we install any service, the service file system will automatically created. Some files, some folders will automatically created, because we need that particular file system to configure. Okay, so this is the concept. Hello, now am I audible? Yes. Now my voice is clear. Rahul. Okay. So, see. Okay. No issue. See, so this is the last concept. So this is the command that provide the package name. So what is the packet that responsible for this particular path? It means this particular location for this particular configuration file. We can say that all things, but mostly sometimes we call this path name, folder name. So for any particular file system, It means for any particular location, one package is responsible. So this package is responsible to create this particular path. And if I goes to /where, then another package is responsible for this. Then www. So which package is responsible? So this is a different package. So for every path, different packages are responsible. It means to create that particular path. So this is the use of this last one command. Then see here, how to install the package? I have already told you. This is the command. If I want to update my package, but at this time we have no recently updated package in my machine. If I have internet connection, then I can use this one command. But how to use this command? See here, yum update, then name of the package. If I want to update this package, then give the name of this particular package. See, so this will give nothing. All is completed. And if you want to update all the packages in your machine, then do this one command. So at this time, we have no recently updated package. We are, because I'm not connecting to the internet. If I use internet, then all the package will install automatically. Okay, I will tell one more command. I have already installed I will tell you this one also. Stop. Give me just one minute only. See, if I use this command yum update, then see what will happen. So it will update some packages in my machine. So how many packages at this time we have? That is one package, and upgrade these all packages. That these are 49, because in this machine I have the internet connectivity and I have also configured my repository that is available to connect to the internet. So from the internet we can install these all the packages. So this is the command that you can use, but you should have to see etc yum.repos.d. See, we have lot of repository. These are not installed by me. These automatically come in my machine, but this one I have created, this one I have installed, but these one, see all the repository. So this is the concept that we can use by the yum. Yum can access the packages not only one location, from different location it will take the path. So what is in this particular file? See, only one concept. So this is for the base OS, this is for the F stream. Which one is F stream? Oh, not, maybe this one, maybe I will check. Then see, then give this particular name. See here, what is in this? This is your base OS. So this is the path, and this is the key name. This is the location of the key, GPG key. So when we install any package, it will check the integrity of that particular package that is digitally signed by the CentOS, not for the Red Hat fault, it's for the CentOS. So this will be digitally signed. And this is the location, this one, mirror. This is the path of the internet that is available, that is provided by the HTTP protocol. So if we use this locally, then give here just file, then this particular location, then the file of that particular packages. This is the name, base, name. So here the mirror, we can also provide here the base URL, then just type this one. This is the key, this is the location. Then if I want to update some packages, another one repository is available for the packages. So this is for only the packages if you want to update. See, lot of information. So these will create, if you want to use your YUM repository from the internet, these all things will be available. So you can install. These are for the extra package, CentOS Plus packages. So different things you can use. So this is the concept related to the package that you can install through the internet. And this is the command, this one. This one is the command. So you can install all the packages from the internet. This one. So see, 49 packages that you can upgrade these packages. And these are the architecture, these are the versions. So you can update all of these packages. If I press yes, then see, it will take some time, then all the packages will be updated in my machine. So this is about the update function. It will take some time, then I will move to my this machine. See. So what is the next concept? So this also completed. This one, to list just, if I want to check the list about the kernel, how many packages we have at this time. So see, if you want to update this one, so you can also update that. So this is a command that if you want to update your kernel version, so first check what is your current kernel version. By using these two commands, we can check the version of the kernel. Then see this one command. So what is the use of uname hyphen r, just only for the, this is my current kernel version. If I want to check this, which machine, see this one. So these all packages installed or not, it will take some time. I will check, taking one another. See, YUM, not YUM, uname and AMA uname hyphen r. So this is my RHEL, this is my CentOS 7 machine. And what is the kernel version in CentOS? In RHEL 7 and CentOS, both are same. So that is 3.10. And this is the version that is released with Enterprise Linux 7. EL7 is Enterprise Linux 7 version. So this is the thing. If I use A option, it will show all of these things. So this is a GNU Linux, and this is Linux version, Docker host. This is the name of my machine. Send this one. So all of these things you can access. If you use this in this machine, that is released in EL8. It means Enterprise Linux 8 version. So this is my 8 version, and that is my 7 version. So you can use, this is my machine name, this is the Linux version, this is my kernel version, this one, and this is the date, GNU Linux. So all of these things can be displayed by using this particular command. So these all things will be complete. YUM remove by using this particular command, we can remove any package. So this is whole thing about the these commands. So any doubt regarding these commands? So I will recall within 1 minute. See, from here I have discussed all of these things. So how to create a YAML repository? It means how to create a repo file. I have already discussed this one. So this is the command to check the help related to that particular YAML command, to display the installed packages. This one to search the packages, and this one to check the detailed information about that particular package. And this is the command. If I don't know the name of the package, what is the package that provide this particular path? So we can use this particular command. And this is for the installation. This is for the updateation. And this is to check the list. This package is available in your machine or not. And this is to check the version of your kernel. This one. So, and this is last one for remove the packages from your machine. So this whole thing will be covered. So this is about the installation, removing all the packages. Then now I will discuss about the, if you want to install and remove all the packages by using the group name. So you can also do this thing by using the groups. And above commands, if you have any doubt, so you can send a text in chat box also, and can also unmute yourself, then you can ask anyone. Then I will start this one concept that is related to installation also, but in a group. Okay. See here, we have some commands related to the groups. Suppose if you want to check how many groups are available in your machine, so this is the command to check the group information. And we have some more commands. So these are the name of the groups. If you want to install all the RPM packages related to the development tools, I want to install, then what command you, suppose you don't know the name of the commands related to the development tools. So this is the name of the group, provide this particular name, then you are able to install all of these commands, all of these packages. So you don't need to different package name, just some predefined groups that is available. Suppose if I want to install the virtualization concept in my machine, but I don't know the name of that particular package, then what I will do? So just type the name of that particular virtualization group name, then you can install all the packages that available for that particular group. So you can install packages in a group also. So these are the commands related to the groups. Then I will discuss this one concept. So how to use this, I will show you. First check repo list all. See, then YAML group. So we have lot of commands. See, type two times tab. See here, these are the commands. I have completed this one, this one, this one, this one also, and this one also, and help also, install also. I have completed these commands. Erase, just type or remove, just. So this one, so these are the related to the groups. So some commands that related to the groups, we can also use these commands. So perform this one commands, group, then type list. So it will show some list related to the groups that is already installed in your machine and that is available in your machine. So these are the available environmental groups. Suppose if you want to install the virtualization concept in my machine, but I don't know the name of the package. Suppose if we have only the CLI concept in my machine, but now I want the GUI concept also. So you don't need to know the name of all of the packages. Just give this particular name by using the group command, and the all packages will be available by using this particular command. If you want to install the container facility, you can also use this one. graphical environment, network server, RPM development, security tools, system tools. So these are the group name. By using these group name, you can install the package. I will show some of them. See this one. I want to install. So these are the commands related to the groups. You can install, you can update also. These are the commands. Group install. Which particulars? Then use single quote. But for the groups, you need single quote or double quote. You can also use. So what is the name of my group? This one. So copy this one, paste here. Then type see how many packages it have. It will take installation size. What is this one? How many packages? These are the packages. So this is the package. The package name is LiveWort. This one, these are the related to the virtualization. This is your hypervisor. These are the tools, base, core, standards, host, some related to the SE Linux packages. So this is the main package that you should know about. The this is WORT manager. So these are related to the virtualization. If you want to install, if you want to create the VM in your Linux machine, so you can use KVM function, KVM kernel based virtual machines. So you should install these packages. If I want to use this one, so we can type just yes, then all packages will be installed. But I don't need this one. I just type a small package name, that is group list. Which one? This one. This has, this will take less time to install. Then type install, then single quote, give name of this particular. So this will take only just 29 installation MB size and 23 packages, small size these have. Then just type Y. All packages will be installed. So it will take less time. So this is the concept, and these all the packages that we don't know the name of any package. So we can install these by using the group also. So this is concept related to the group. Suppose C1 and other commands also. So we can also use info command, same group list, same like just yum, install, update, all of the functions have the same. So this is installation command, this is group, this is the same thing. Suppose if I want to check the information related to this particular group, so what is the use of this particular group? So you can use info and give the name of that particular group. So type this one. See this one. So this is the information about this particular group. So you can take, this is the name, this is the information, RPM packages, mandatory package, these are the packages related to the RPM. Same thing for the virtualization also. So you can use all of the information related to that particular group. So this whole thing will save. See this one. If you install, if you have installed any package in your machine and you want to reverse that particular concept, then what you will do? See here. We have one more command that is related to the history. Yum, that is, where is the history? where is the history command? History is not available. Okay. H. Okay. HISTORY. This one. But that is not available in this particular after completion the tab. So see, I have installed this particular package. I have also installed this one. Suppose I want to perform the reverse function. I want to remove this particular package. I want to remove this particular package by using the history command. Then what I will do? Just nothing. Undo. Then type this particular ID, this one. So it will remove that package. It means reverse the concept from the history. If you remove that, then you can install. If you install that, then it will remove. It will perform the reverse function. Undo means reverse. So you can use this one. See, what is the use of this? This will remove that packages. Because at this time, what is the function of this? Install. Then this will perform the reverse function that available in this particular ID. See, it will remove all the packages, then type Y. So this is the use of the history command. So you can use the history also. See, again history, do. See here, what is the number of this particular? So at this, we do the removal function. What is the action? Remove. And I want to install again. And what I will do? Just change the number. Nothing. So this is concept about the history. So see here. What is the use of this command? It will install all the 9 packages that you have removed in the earlier command. So this is my recently command. Then you can, if you type yes, all the packages will be installed automatically. So different commands that are used to installation, it can be installed individually by using the RPM, yum also, yum group also, history also, lot of commands. So you should know about these, but mostly we use some of them, not all of them. So this is the use of this particular command. So if you want to use the history display, it will show the display information about the summary. If you install any package, if you install any, remove any package. So by using the transaction, we can do this concept. So you just undo option for perform the reverse transaction. It means revert function. So you can do that. So just this is a command you can use. And we have one more concept also, that is called module. If you want to install some modules, it means some features that is related to your packages. So you can also use the module function. Module, it is a set of RPM packages. So in yum functionality, there is another one concept that is called module. Module is just nothing, it's a set of RPM packages. So we have already predefined module names. If you want to install only Ruby function, .NET, Java, so you can install the packages by using the module utility. See, I will give you one example, then you can understand this concept. So this is same command, module list, check just first list, how many modules are available for that particular package. So you can install, suppose just like you want to install a Perl, Python, Java, .NET, anything you want to install, you can install all of these things. If you want to install just as this one package, so give the name of the package, then you can install. Then type the command, your module, then install, then give the name of the package, this one. This is to check the profile also. So this is the functionality. See this one. This one is a command to check the package, to install the package by using the module command also. So module also available. See, these are some commands you can use by using the module functionality. You can also remove, install, disable this one. So this is the concept related to the module, these ones. So this is the last concept that I will tell you. If you want to remove, you can also remove this one. See here. EM module. Where is the module? Okay, not available. No issue. See, these are the commands related to the modules. Then type list. This one. So different modules are available in your machine. Suppose if you want to install the word function, then just give this particular name, then this will be available in your system. If you want to install the Ruby, this one, Ruby 2.5, Redis. These are the tools that you should have to know about when you do a course name, that is DevOps. For the DevOps, you want to install container, Ruby, Redis, Swig, Squid. So these are to be known. This is just a, this one, also install. So Perl, Python, PHP, for the programming concept, Nginx, you want to install Nginx 1.4, Nginx 1.6, MySQL, Maven. These are the tools that you should know when you learn about the DevOps, development and operations. So these are the tools, MariaDB. So you should know about the module also, IDM, HTTPD, all the HTTP function also available here also. Container, you want to install the containerization technology, free Redis. So these are predefined groups. By using these groups, you can install the packages. Suppose I will tell one. Suppose if I want to install the Nginx and this particular package, so you can also give the name module install and give the name of this particular package. So it will install Nginx, all modules, all the file system. I have already told you, if I install this particular package, it will create some files, some directories, some the file system that is already created in your environment. If you install any package, common, stream, mail, HTTP, Perl, image, filter, all the packages will be available in your system. So just type Y, your Nginx function will be installed in your machine. And it also provided the file system also, and all the things will be available in your system. So this is the concept how to install, and if I want to remove this one, just type the remove command. So this package will automatically remove from your system. So I have completed all of these things. If you have any doubt regarding the installation, remove, so you can ask. Mostly we use RPM sometimes, and sometimes we use EM function. But EM has a lot of concepts that I told you. So Rahul, Vijay, and anyone has doubt, so please. I want to shut down this one. Okay. So today I complete only these sessions. In the next session, I will complete which particular chapter, I will tell you. So these whole chapters will complete. Only this last chapter will remain in SA1. So SA1 will complete. So this is the last concept in this that I will discuss this particular chapter, that is 15th chapter in SA1 book. So I will start this on 24. So today is 22, 24. Then 24th, on 24th I will complete this chapter and your SA1 will complete. SA1, this one. That is Thursday. So if you want to ask anything, you can ask. So this is the next session. For remembering myself, so I have typed these all things. So I can start this. Okay. Any other doubt? If you have, then I will end the session. Okay, I will ask you some questions. You have no question, then I will ask some questions. See, I will take a test. I will take a small test. So give me the answer of this particular question in my WhatsApp. I will give you only 5 minutes to complete this particular question. I will provide 5 minutes. If you have no time, then you can perform this. Rahul, you have time, so perform this one, and Gopi and Vijay also. If you have time, then perform this particular question. This one. So what is the answer of this one? So Vijay, you have my WhatsApp number, so you can also send this in my WhatsApp. So I will check your answer is correct or not. So within 5 minutes, please provide the answer. Rahul, Gopi and Vijay, for all of you. So I wait for 5 minutes. Then I pause the recording.